In previous lecture, we have taken the information about the story of Sindabad sailors, some part. Now we will go ahead. What happened after that? In the previous session, we have seen that all the people aboard the ship and they went from that place. But the Sindabad alone was on the sea there, and he had spent the whole night on the sea. And in the next day morning, he reached on one island, and then he was very tired there, but he catch the island shore there, and he got relaxed when he saw the some shady fruits for eating. That time he became very happy, and after that what happened we will see now. Luckily this was a time when the king of that island sent his horses to the seashore with the grooms. Now see students, when the Sindabad reached on the island of the island seashore, that time he was walking towards the shady fruits tree. That time the king of that kingdom sent his horses to seashore with the grooms. Grooms means what? Grooms means the person who takes care of the horses. Grooms means a person, those are taking the care of horses. So the groom saw Sindabad and gave him food and drink. Then they took him to the king. The king was impressed by the way Sindabad told him about what had happened. He asked Sindabad to stay with him and work as an officer of the king at the court. Now see students, when the Sindabad was on the island seashore, that time groom came there, and that groom of the king given the food and drink to the Sindabad, and after that they had taken to the Sindabad towards the king. And when the Sindabad told his story to the king, that time the king was very impressed by the Sindabad, that the Sindabad was very brave and very honest person. So for that the king offered him to stay with him, and he will work as an officer on the king's court, of the king at the court. So Sindabad stayed on the port for some days, and he learning a lot of things from the king and the people those are in that kingdom, and he kept on telling them about the other cities and ports that he had visited. Now the Sindabad had many voyages in his life, and he was talking with the people about the different ports and different voyages. And at the port, Sindabad often made inquiries about any ships coming from or going to Baghdad, but no such ship ever come to that port. Now on that port, the Sindabad was always asking about the Baghdad ship, but nobody has given the answer that the Baghdad ship had came here or not. Mean student, जब वो port पे job कर रहा था, उस वक्त वो सारे लोगों को पूछताछ करते रहता था कि सिंधबाद बगदाद से कोई एखादा ship यहाँ पे आ गया है या नहीं. अगर है, if it is there, then you will inform me. He is giving such kind of information to that people there. Now, after passing some days, what happened there? One day, a ship arrived at this island with a lot of merchandise. Sindabad was at the quay when the cargo from that ship was being unloaded. Now, one day on that port, one ship came there, and it is having a lot of merchandise, and Sindabad was at the quay, and the cargo from the ship was being unloaded. He was surprised to see that his own name was marked on the sum of the boxes. Now what happens, students? See there, the sheep came on the port, and that sheep was belonged to the Sindabad only, because whatever merchandise came with that sheep, that all the boxes belonged to Sindabad, because Sindabad's own name was marked on that boxes. Then he went to see the captain of the ship. At the first, captain could not believe that it was the same Sindabad that they had seen drowning in the sea. Now the captain of the ship saw there that the Sindabad had already drowned into the sea. Then how it can be possible? How he don't believe that he is a Sindabad, that Sindabad is alive here. Then he recognized him. He was overjoyed to see Sindabad alive. He gave him back all his merchandise. Now that captain was very honest person, and when he saw that our Sindabad is alive here, he gave his all merchandise back. So from that goods thus got back, Sindabad presented the most valuable items to the king of the island, saying, "Please accept this, your majesty. You have been very kind and very generous." Now that king was living with the king from so many days, so he shows his gratitude towards the king, that he, when he got all his merchandise back, that time he given some merchandise to the king as a gift. He presented that most valuable things to the king, and the king was pleased. He too gave Sindabad many valuable gifts when he, Sindabad, left the island with the merchant ship. Now when the Sindabad got his own ship, the captain of the ship, and all his merchandise, that time the Sindabad decided to go back from that place, and he wants to go back in the Baghdad through that ship. And so the king decided to give him some valuable gifts, and he gave on him, and he said to goodbye to the king, and he went away from that place. So students, in this way Sindabad was a very honest person, generous person. For this, the God is also help him, and the God comes to the home of king here, and he saved his life, and he also got the success on this first voyage, and he returned safely home, and he got a new life there. So students, in this way the Sindabad story is over. Suppose if you want to know what happened to Sindabad afterwards, after this voyages, you can read the rest of the story in his fantastic voyages. Means the another story you will get in the second voyage. So till this, we will take stop here. Thank you and have a nice day.